for? What did you come here for? If you're just gonna get backhanded and lose everything.
Run.
Let this be a lesson, kid. Make good life choices, or you'll end up like her. Now, what do I do with
Damon?
Oh, Frank.
What did you do?
I fucked you up good, didn't I? Guess you really don't know when to quit. Glad to see you back on your feet.
Chloe.
Frank.
You don't really want to do this again, do you? Okay. Then I don't want to.
This dude, oh, he got a knife on him, bro.
Come on, man. Fuck you.
Oh my god.
You just gave me a concussion.
Oh, he kicked you in the head.
Rachel. Your daughter. She.
And Frank's fighting this dude with a stabbed shoulder? With no weapon?
I just got a concussion.
Don't kick you in the head for fun. Like, that was so honest. You were not getting back up after the kick. After the kick to the ribs, bro, you were down for the count. But he said, let me make sure she stays down forever.
Chloe Price. Where's Frank? Or Damon?
Your friend, Frank, took care of Damon.
Ooh.
You don't need to worry about them right now.
Ooh. Frank got it like that.
Why do I need to sit down, and why didn't you help me out for something? Why didn't you wake me up?
If Frank's nice like that, bro.
Are you okay?
Shoulder stabbed? Won the fight against the armed man?
I am so, so sorry for
Rachel. Can never know.
We gotta put respect on Frank's name, bro.
I think you need help. Let me call someone or something.
W. Frank. Listen.
What James did, hiring that thug, shooting me up with
he's a piece of shit. And I promise that
Rachel can never know.
Tell me why. Doesn't she deserve to know what her father did?
No. Rachel deserves a loving father.
That is very true.
A father who cares for her.
James is a liar.
James is a desperate man who loves his daughter. And she loves him. Tell her what happened here. And you'll take that away from her. Forever.
Mm-hmm.
And just what is James protecting her from? You? She wants to meet you, Sarah.
I'm tired of Chloe thinking she put her nose in everything.
She wants to meet her mother. I can never be that for her.
That's very true.
Why are you saying all this?
Because James is right. He's taken something from me that I might not ever get back. But he's right.
That sucks.
Everybody's broken, Sarah.
Oh? Does everybody abandon their own child
so she's
for
15.
15 years? Does everybody
take
money to stay
away? No, she left after the child was...
But how old was the child?
You're here now.
She was gone for 15 years.
That's what matters.
What do you...
Rose and the dad were married for 13 years.
Rachel needs you.
So it took 2 years between that.
No loss.
Maybe she was one.
I lost my father and my best friend.
I lost my father.
Oh, it was 2 years ago. My fault. I kept on saying like 6 years in the first part.
Car accident. He was picking up my mother from the grocery store. And a truck.
A semi-truck.
Light. And...
A 16-wheeler. 53 feet.
I'm sorry.
Emphasis on that. It was a huge truck. Died a horrible death.
I load trucks at work. I know what type of truck that was. The driver.
Every pain. Every fear. Gone. No more sadness. No more grief. Why would anyone not want to feel that way? Ever.
Oh, man. She got right back to being hooked on it, bro.
I don't know anything about addiction, but I know what it's like to be needed by someone. It gives you strength you never knew you had.
Facts.
Rachel needs you.
Rachel needs her family.
I recognize I might not know what the fuck I'm talking about here, but I wish you could know how amazing Rachel is.
I know.
She's fearless. She's brilliant and talented. And she feels so much. She's so strong.
She's had a good life. Raised in a loving home, given opportunities I could never give her.
At least talk to her. She's felt like something's been missing her whole life. She told me so. That something was you.
She didn't miss anything. She has a perfect family.
Even without all this shit, the Ambers are far from perfect. James is an elitist asshole, and Rose lets him walk all over her.
Maybe. What Rachel needs, though, is not to have her father taken away from her.
He doesn't deserve...
It's not about James. It's not about me, and it's not about you. It's about Rachel. Tell her what James did, and you'll be killing him for her. You understand that?
I understand that personally.
You lost your father. Do you really want to put Rachel through that?
The worst mistake you ever made was giving Rachel up. That's what you said in your letter to her.
You read that.
You don't have to make the same mistake twice.
Nothing can change the mistakes I made. I'll never get to be Rachel's mother. Not really. But there's one thing I can still do for her. The only thing I can do. Let me give her the father she deserves.
You already gave her that a long time ago when you
the one
freaking
raised
abandoned her.
Protected her. The one who loves her more than anything. You can do whatever you want, Chloe. You have the power. What you have to decide is whether you're going to protect Rachel or cause her even more hurt.
Is she just gonna walk off from me like that?
So please, tell her I was never here. Let her have what peace she can without me.
Wait!
I'm not gonna give her a Rachel bracelet because that's mine.
I'll take care of her, you know.
I believe you. Goodbye.
I feel like if I had asked her not to leave, she would have left anyway.
I think I told her to keep the bracelet, and she just said, nah. You keep it.
Good. I wasn't about to give her no bracelet. Dang, I just spawned right here? What?
You drove.
I don't even got no concussion, no bruises, no nothing?
Nah, bro. You got a dent in your head, bro. But it's okay.
Oh, I just like how shy I made her.
Hello?
They just... She's... Okay. Only Rose woke up.
Hello?
Rachel's just fine.
Hello?
So. Wait, what is that
Hello?
From?
Hello? The vine. Hello? They pour the water on her and she's sleeping? Hello?
Well, I know she'll be thrilled to see you when she wakes up. Maybe come back a little later.
Maybe let me sleep with her?
Hey.
Whoa. Pause.
Not like that. Pause. Let's rewind.
No diddy.
You need your rest.
Can I
let me have
to
a summer party with my friend?
Alone? For a minute?
Diddy party. Okay, oh, she soon. Looks sick.
We'll be right outside.
That looks stoic as hell.
How are you feeling? Like I got stabbed? Doc says there'll be a sick scar. Maybe a tattoo is in order. Fuck yeah. We never actually escaped. Did we?
Nope.
We've got time. All the time in the world. So, how did everything go? Rachel, I've got to tell you something. Hey. What's wrong? I failed you. I couldn't find her. I'm so sorry. Funny. You seem so confident. I really thought you'd find her.
Yeah. Me too.
Maybe we can try tomorrow. Maybe she hasn't left town yet.
Of course.
I know. Wherever she is, she loves you very much. How do you know that? Because why should she be any different from the rest of us?
Living life with this on my conscious, so oh no, okay. So I still have it on my conscious, and I feel horrible.
W Frank, bro. Oh, Frank, a real one. He took care of it.
So, did he kill him?
He had to have killed him, bro. He's got the knife as bounty. With the broken shoulder, no knife? Aw, Frank the coolest. Hey, Frank cool as hell, bro. Except for in the first game.
In the first game, he's still cool as hell, so he's just going through the same kind of mourning. Look, he spilled some beer for him.
For his homeboy. He killed his homeboy for Chloe and the... That's real. Oh my goodness.
Oh my goodness.
I didn't even know that they were married in the first game. Well, congratulations, Joyce and David.
And what happens to Elliot? Elliot was in the house.
He was kicked out of school.
Why? Because he's a weirdo?
Yeah, bro. You called the cops on him. He was talking crazy on the cops' line. You're asking me to help. That's crazy that they don't talk to you about, the dad doesn't talk to you about all the struggles you went through.
It's okay, it's unneeded, we already know.
You know, you only know that because I was talking about it from my playthrough. Ah.
Why does he want to talk to her anymore? Why does she want to talk to him anymore? What happened? Is that when Victoria starts talking to him, or?
Ugh. Is he part of the Vortex Club? Ah. We got milk duds. Did she just littered? She's so disrespected. Bro, you never earn an ounce of respect. Good. Fantastic, beautiful game.
Absolutely. She's probably so bummed that she couldn't find her mom. But I for real stood dropped out of high school, like I just didn't go back.
I guess so. Now that that's over, I'm gonna have to say there is a secret ending that I didn't unlock. The Chloe we know and love. All blue, purple. Oh, here we go.
That's where we see it.
What?
We saw it in the first game, but they're about to write down. Rachel is here.
You got a tattoo? Yeah. Oh, right. Chloe didn't have that before. Right?
She did.
She did?
No.
Oh. She got a tattoo. Empty. Oh, they said that in the play. She said, when bro arrived there, he exclaimed, "Hell is empty."
What's the secret ending, and how could you unlock it?
There's something. There was a bunch of steps you had to do. That you could get her to meet with her mom, and like you could, they get like a interaction with each other, and then she becomes cool with her mom.
That's horrible. I wanted the secret ending.
I didn't get it.
So it didn't show when she goes missing.
And I didn't even choose the ending you did. I told her. Actually, it was just. Why is it the only one?
This is all the stats? That doesn't sound right.
Click L1.
What's L1? Oh. That's... These are all the stats.
That's it. Keep on clicking L1 on repeat. Word? Oh, wait, there's a next... Wait, no, don't click it. Let's start with this one. Go ahead.
Okay, 51% of the players chose to tell Rachel the truth. We can definitely tell that this is at a tie here. I chose not to tell her the truth because you know what? Her mom is right. It is what Rachel needs. She had a very balanced life, and obviously, yeah, she does feel like she's been living a lie, but she's been living a very privileged life. So if we would have told her the truth, then it just would have ruined the balance of everything at home and everything. And she really would have been, you know, going crazy, a little bit angry. So now she doesn't have a mom and she doesn't have a dad, and she's gonna have this little angst, this whole thing that Chloe was going through.
Thank you. It does make a lot of sense. As you can see, on 51% and 49%, there is pros and cons to each side. On my playthrough, I chose to tell her the truth because I was thinking, like, respectfully, I don't care about what the dad feels, and I don't care about how the mom feels, bro. I'm only caring about what Rachel feels like, and she said she wants to know the truth. If she can handle it, if she can't handle it, I don't know, but I'm gonna be there either way. And so I chose to tell her the truth. And what happened was, she, like, cries there on the bed, and then her parents come in, ask her why she's crying, and then her dad tries to help her, and she's like, no. And then she's, like, almost the same sequences after that, though. It's like everything's the same. I just told the truth because I was like, why am I listening to this dude that's been lying to us? He hid the fact that he was doing any interaction with the mom. He lied about her mom for her whole life. And then after we found out that that was a different mom, that's her real mom, he still kept hidden the fact that he was hiding her letters from Rachel. Like, she probably wouldn't have felt so strongly about this. It probably would have never blown up like that if he gave her the letters periodically, you know?
Periodically sounds crazy. I would have just showed her the letters.
I mean, he should have just loaded them as she was getting them. So it would have been periodically.
No, because then that's another talk, and maybe he just wasn't ready to have that talk. Like, that's a talk.
That shouldn't be something he should decide,
hey,
though.
Hey, Rachel, so... You got a mom! Two moms. This is your real mom. She wrote you. You know?
Yeah, now she's been living a double life her whole life.
But I feel like after he tells her this, and maybe if he just says he was waiting for the right time because of everything that's happened... And again, she did not deserve to just be able to just show up out of nowhere when she decides she wants to be a mom. Show her. But I want you to know that she does care for you. And she does love you. It's just she cannot be a mom. She's not clean. She's had battled substance abuse. It's dangerous. And he did say so. It is a disease. It is.
It is. But from my perspective, I was like, this Rachel might not even want her to be her mom. She might be cool with Rose being her mom. She just wants to see what her birth mother's like. She don't gotta have another mom in her life. She could just know her origins, you know? Like, it don't gotta be like Rose gets replaced. She don't even want to be with the dean anyway. The dean's whack.
The DA.
So I was like, it doesn't matter. Me and Rachel are going to get out of here eventually, so they could do whatever they want because me and Rachel are out the city, blow this popsicle stand. Type B.
Blow this popsicle stand for sure.
But yeah, that was just my perspective on it.
I didn't want her to put her through the same hurt that I've been through, so that's just my perspective. And they keep repeating that to her with that. I know that you've been through this hurt. Doesn't mean that you have to put her through that, though. I know you understand here. And I know you mean well, but you don't make her experience
I don't
that.
Mean well, bro.
Oh.
What is this? Some booth photos. Well, who are those people?
I know
who
are those people. I hate that they make these photos look so different. Dude.
Oh, that sucks. They did not show me this, bro.
Are
oh,
you
that sucks.
Right now?
Oh, that's trash, bro.
Dude.
That's trash, bro.
They didn't show you that? Are you being
I don't. I must have just turned off the game after that because I do not remember seeing this at all, bro. That's sorry as hell.
That just sent me shivers.
That's sick. You're telling me you're gonna let her die without her knowing the truth, bro? She gonna die without ever knowing the truth? Nah, bro, I can't let her go out like that. She gotta know who she is. She gonna die. No disrespect, but like, bro, respectfully, a bright life instead of a long one, bro. You could go out like a star. Or you could go out like a. Like a turtle, like a snail, bro. I'm choosing her to go out like a star, bro.
Oh my God.
I'm not letting her go out like a snail, just living a quiet, peaceful life. She's not built for that. You know who her mom is.
I don't like this plot line.
I'm not letting her die without knowing the truth, bro.
I don't like that plot line.
That sucks. That made me feel a lot better about my choice, bro. Yeah, yours reasonable, but she still died 2 seconds later. She's getting the truth before she goes out, bro, respectfully. That was sick. Sick in a gross way.
All right, guys, so I'm gonna cry. I really hope you enjoyed us playing this game. Raw reaction. I am traumatized. This kind of changed, this altered my brain chemistry. All in all, this is such a beautiful game, and you've heard me repeat this throughout the whole gameplay that I do love this game. And I think no matter which Life is Strange that I play, I think by far this is going to be my favorite one. Like, this is truly what friendship is, even though they had just been friends for about 4 days. And then from then on, you know, that's what friendship, I think, to me is all about. And I think that weighs more than, you know, Max and Chloe's friendship. Personally, I think.
I love this one. This one's great. I love this one so much. I think it gave me, like, more perspective on, like, how I want to live my life. Because, like, it's just, like, I know the truth hurts. And, like, ignorance is bliss and things like that. But you know what? Just going out, like, in a sad way, bro, it just makes me want to know as much as I can now. And, like, you know, I don't want to just have this, like, a mediocre life, even if it's longer, bro. If my life could be noteworthy at all, something noteworthy. But shorter, like, I prefer to go out like a star. Respectfully. Burnout. Live short, but live bright. But I'm gonna say the first one, the Max one's my favorite, because I just felt like I resonated with Max for how much she would do for her best friend, you know? I was like, there's no length that
but
I wouldn't go.
Is that, like, just a moral thing? Because you have the power, so that's what you would do. She had no powers when she was willing to. The link she was willing to go for.
Yes, she was. Too. But, like, it was, like, such a grander scale. On.
But solely because she had powers.
But solely because it was the world versus the best friend. So I was like.
That was deep.
Yeah. So I was like, oh, this is how I feel. It's like it's a more accurate version of my best friend.
No, thank you.
Personally, I was like, yeah. Forget the city, bro. I don't care.
Bay over bay.
Type beat. But this one's really good.
Yeah, this game is really heartbreaking.
It is. I made me forget that she was even gone. And we still don't know what happened between her and Frank. She's 16 here.
Really,
Frank's like 23.
I really wish they would have dove into that, though.
So, whatever happened had to be very... It better have been when she was 18, bro, because she dies at 18. Frank's a grown man, so he better lock in for whatever.
I would appreciate that more.
It better have been super recent. Either way, I want to see both of them alive in the next game, because it's like based on parallels.
Yeah.
So there could be a world where Rachel's alive and Chloe's alive, bro. And I want to see that, bro. Let me see that.
In my head, Rachel's still alive. Rachel didn't die.
Rachel got photo clapped, bro.
No, she didn't.
We saw her body in a dish.
No, we didn't. I didn't see that.
I threw up.
I erased it. Happened.
I threw up.
It didn't happen.
The small, I threw up. Anyways.
Thank you guys for watching so much and joining us. I hope that you guys catch us for the next game. We'll keep this series strong. Up until the new one comes out.
Yeah.
Perfect timing. Years for us.
You saying we're playing the brother one?
Yeah. Brethren. Hey, brother.
Hey, brother. How's the window, sister, brother, mother? Hello, brother.
Perfect teens, perfect. All right, guys.
Sis barf.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for watching, like, and subscribe.
Yeah, make sure you leave a like, comment, and subscribe. Laters.
Peace.
Peace.